And now I'm going to go back to CMake. Sorry, not CMake, Mesa. And try and rerun the build again for this. Now, if you remember, I left the source directory there, so we should be able to just go into Mesa and then build. And then I'll have to set these Gallium options, the Gallium and DRI driver variables. So I'm going to set that one to Crocus. And what was the other one called? DRI drivers, not DRM. DRI. .965. Then recall the command used to build it, or rather configure it. So that's that command there. And let's see if it now works. No, it's still a problem. So I'm not sure why, according to the book, should be allowed to build these drivers with these specific settings, and it's not actually working. So unfortunately, what I'm going to do for the moment, again, Mesa is going to be a package that I'll be rebuilding, I think. Let me just check the dependencies. I'm sure it will, because normally it's got lots of dependencies. In fact, installed that one. I've installed that one now. Right, okay, I'll need to install that one ready for Plasma. So yes, I will be reinstalling it. And there's another additional, I can't remember if I've installed that or not now, but that's quite a useful tool to have to allow the sensors on your motherboard to be, and even on the chip as well, maybe on the graphics card, to be displayed. So instructions below, the yellow VM with R600 installed, you need to volume. Okay, well, it's not actually complaining about R600 or AMD GPU, it's just saying that SWRest Vulkan requires Gallium SWRest. And that indicates to me that the hardware acceleration is not being identified. So it even says actually 2.1.2.1 does not select Crocus. Now, if you select Auto, which is interesting because Crocus is the one I need. So if I selected Auto, which seemed to work yesterday, that's not going to work with the looks of it. I could try building Gallium only drivers, but for Intel drivers, specify Crocus for i965. Yeah, so Crocus is definitely right. That was this link here. So it's rather confusing. Let's try setting this back to Crocus, and I'll try. It did seem to indicate there's maybe some sort of conflict between these two if they're the same. No, that still doesn't want to play. SWREST Vulkan requires Gallium SWREST. But I'm not selecting that. Okay, all I can do to alleviate this, get around this, is to install Crocus and SWREST, I think. Yeah, it's gone through with that. Now this should go through to the through past the LLVM because we've now got that, so we should be able to. Yeah, I think that's. No, okay. Runtime dependency modules, AMD GPU missing. Looks like it does still need AMD GPU, even though I've not selected that either. Another subproject directory or a LLVM map file was found. So, yeah, I seem to remember this is what happened to me last time. It seemed that somehow there's dependency on LLVM via Mesa that requires AMD GPU, even if you haven't requested it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video to investigate this a bit further because it doesn't seem right to me, and as I think I mentioned previously, when I've built this on Gen 2, just putting in, or in fact leaving out AMD GPU, I just use BPF and x86 and that compiles. But I don't know if that's something Gen 2 have done or if it's configured slightly. So I'm going to, like I said, just pause the video for a while and investigate this to see if I can find anything about what the problem is. Okay, so that looks like it's built successfully. So let's take a look about testing it. So Ninja test with 33 subtests known to fail. So let's copy that. Okay, I'm not sure if my mouse batteries are running out. It's taking a while for the mouse to wake up, but let's carry on. So I'll time this as well. Okay, so I've got this error again about encoding, but aside from that, it looks like a complete pass. Did it say all 33 tests? So whether that's something specific to the AMD GPU, which is kind of what the documentation seems to be leaning towards. I'm not sure, but at least we've got some passes. So let's now install. And that looks like that's that. Install optional documentation. As the root user, so I don't think this will work because we didn't install it. Let's have a look, see what's in the docs directory. There is something there now. I'm not sure what they are. RST files. .docs.star. Yeah. Don't recognise what RST files are. Let's have a quick look at one. With our text files, okay, here, yeah. I think we can run that in. Maybe there would have been extra documentation. Or am I thinking of... I'm thinking of the other VM documentation, actually. Yes, I am, yeah. So that's why it doesn't look too unusual. Okay. Right, so that is Mesa completed, but as I said, that's going to be... a reinstall for Wayland, at least the Wayland protocols. So let's check where we are. Chapter 24. This is just part of the X window installation, but that needs a rebuild. So let's tidy this up now. Okay, and now we can move on. So we've got these two graphical test demo programs. Well, one's a graphical program, this one provides information about the installed geo libraries. We can actually run this one. The GLX gears does need a GUI to run in. If I run it, it will complain in some way. Yeah. Whereas the GLX info should provide us with a load of information. Okay, so maybe something's not installed yet, then something else is not installed. Let's try doing sbin. All right, so this still needs a display. So you can see there the error is different because I had to run ldconfig to get the libraries loaded in the cache. So that's why I run that command. And you can see the GLX program does need a graphical display, so that's why it's not reporting anything.